Among the 2,100 political prisoners of Burma, also known as Myanmar, Nyi Nyi Aung remains distinct. Nyi Nyi Aung is the only U.S. citizen in Burma's prison. Nyi Nyi, before becoming a U.S. citizen, had spent years lobbying for democracy in Burma. Since receiving citizenship in 2002, Nyi Nyi traveled back and forth to Burma. It was on his fifth trip to see his ailing mother that he was captured.
Frightening, scared. Is that what's going to happen?
Nyi Nyi even kept the secret of going back to Burma from his fiancé, Wawa Jha. Wawa understands why he went, because she knows of his great love for his native country, and he went to visit his mother, who was imprisoned for her involvement in the 2007 Saffron Revolution. Nyi Nyi has always felt guilty for her imprisonment.
Some people are hesitant about Nyi Nyi's case. You know, some people say Nyi Nyi knew of the dangers of going back to Burma, yet he hid it. He hid going back to Burma, mm-hmm. even to his own wife. I've read that somewhere. Mm-hmm. And what do you say to people like this? What do you say to that comment when people say he knew of the dangers mm-hmm. and he risked himself?
We have people sitting outside, not involved in the movement, and just analyzing it, what's going on, criticizing who is doing what and who is not doing. Instead of sitting outside or not doing anything, at least we got to do something, right? And he is a true believer that he is doing something to make a change.
Wawa wrote an article in the Wall Street Journal talking about her disappointment in the U.S. government for not doing enough to help a U.S. citizen. Nyi Nyi Aung is a refugee from Burma, and according to U.S. law, when one seeks asylum in the U.S., the United States cannot take responsibility when the refugee actively seeks to go back to his native land. A refugee is defined as a person who is in fear of persecution and who fear returning back to his native land.
The United States, it's a democratic country. U.S. cherish for the freedom, peace, and democracy. And U.S., United States, should not be neglecting the human rights violation. He is the American citizen. He is one and only American citizens who are wrongfully, illegally imprisoned.
Around the world, people are watching and listening about Nyi Nyi's imprisonment. Human Rights Watch and Amnesty International are particularly interested in Nyi Nyi's case and distributing statements and making announcements of his treatment in prison. In prison, Nyi Nyi has been tortured and deprived of food, water, and sleep. He is denied access to see U.S. consulars or a doctor. His health is a serious problem. The House of Representatives sent a letter to Burma's General Thun Shwe urging Nyi Nyi's release. U.S. Congressman Chris Van Hollen of Maryland says Nyi Nyi's treatment in prison has violated international laws.
They've made up some charges against him as an excuse to hold him, but the fact of the matter is what they're worried about is the fact that he's promoting democracy within Burma. So, number one, we have an absolute interest in making sure that our citizens are not illegally held. And number two, we have a larger interest, I think, in Burma in promoting greater democracy.
Wawa says that she is confident in the strong support system she has behind her. Beth Schwenke is one of the lawyers for Nyi Nyi Aung's case.
I think the incentive for the junta to release Nyi Nyi is that the United States would look very favorably on it. Obviously, you know, Nyi Nyi's been imprisoned on sham charges, and for a government that claims to wish to engage with the United States, this is an untenable course going forward.
This is not the first time in which the U.S. has called for the release of a U.S. citizen tried in Burma. Just last summer, John Yeadaw, a U.S. citizen, was tried for entering Aung San Suu Kyi's home. Democrat Senator Jim Webb went to Burma and met with senior leaders of the military to get John Yeadaw. However, the fate of Nyi Nyi Aung, a U.S. citizen of Burmese descent, still remains unknown. Kaylin, Voice of America, Washington, D.C.